Finally, ladies and gentlemen, Blood Necro will be the number one with all these amazing, unique changes. Hell, they even invented a new stat for Blood Surge, making it suck even harder. Now that sounded wrong. And to put the cherry on top, they made Bone Spirit even stronger with one single unique change. The Blood Moon Breaches, they used to give us 70% bonus over power damage, which is already good. Well, buckle up, that's now 150% over power damage multiplied. We're used to top Bone Spirit builds doing billions of damage. That will be even crazier now, as the Blood Moon Breaches on top also give another 115% over power damage plus. The only thing that got taken away was a damage reduction from enemies affected by curse skills. That's a huge boost to Spirit, Blood Surge, Bloodlands, and Blood Wave builds. And yes, Blood Wave got a whopping damage increase from 150% to 450%, which ties very good in with a Bloodlands Bully build and some other unique changes. But first, let's talk about the exciting new Blood Surge. And this is with Cruel's Embrace. Used to give us overpower damage, core damage, a little bit of Blood Surge, and it consumes corpses to give us even more damage multiplier. This is good because it finally allows for more boss damage, since we just have to make corpses by using minions together with our Blood Surge. Now the gloves are giving us a maximum life percentage, but 10% more maximum life, and you can masterwork this and greater affix this. Blood Surge another 4 ranks up to 5, and Tides of Blood. Tides of Blood being the passive that gives us 15% more overpower damage multiplier and double that if we're healthy. And that can be masterworked up to another 3 ranks. The real interesting thing though is, Blood Surge drains plus 3 times from elites. The way Blood Surge reads is following: draw blood from enemies dealing 20% damage and expel a Blood Nova dealing 70% damage. Blood Surge Nova damage is increased by 5% per enemy drained up to 50%, against a boss that used to be a 5% damage increase. Now with the Altered Cruel's Embrace, we're at least getting another 15% with plus 3 drains. But not only that, if we masterwork this glove up, we could probably see this at 5, maximum probably 6 bonus drains. And 6 bonus drains is another 30% damage multiplier on getting more ranks to Blood Surge, more ranks to Tides of Blood. And we're not even done yet, because the new Death Speaker's Pendant that causes mini Novas around our minions with Blood Surge gives us now a bonus of attack speed instead of essence cost reduction, and plus 1 essence per enemy drained by Blood Surge. Not useful versus the bosses, but very useful while dungeoneering. You still have to take care of your essence consumption, probably using the new Ring of Starless Skies. But this also now gives another 5 ranks in Blood Surge. That's 10 ranks alone with the gloves plus, another 4 ranks if you get the Harlequin Crest. The Ring of Starland Skies could be another 2 more ranks to Blood Skills, and then 3 ranks in Coil Assessed Blood. Taking the Death Speaker's Pendant with the new Cruel's Embrace and the huge buff to Blood Moon Breaches, your Blood Surge is going to do more damage than it has ever done in quite a while. And there's another thing to factor in, because they just simply buffed our Paragon board. Yes, the Bloodbath Legendary node is now 70% instead of 35% bonus to our overpower damage. Just... why not? And yes, this also boosts very well the Bone Spirit, who did billions of damage, now on top of this too. And then the Blood Begets Legendary node gets buffed. It is now going up to a total bonus of 50% instead of 30 when you pick up Blood Orbs, and every Blood Orb is a 10% multiplier. That's actually really good. I only have to pick up 5 Blood Orbs to get the 50% bonus. And picking up Blood Orbs yields one thing: Bloodlands and the Gorquil aspect. This is the Mutilator play that every Bloodlands build plays, because you get 20% bonus damage to Bloodlands. Well, that's now 40% bonus damage to Bloodlands. Oh, and instead of a 5% chance to make a Blood Orb with a Bloodlands, that's a 10% chance, so even twice the chance to create more Blood Orbs. Not all of it, though. The Mutilator plate finally gives 4 ranks in Bloodlands bonus. That's another huge damage multiplier. Every rank just multiplies your damage further, and you get 16% more maximum life. And then you can masterwork this 20% more maximum life, getting the 25% hit on every 4 ranks masterworking, maybe getting a greater affix. But the real interesting thing is the Bloodlands duration increase on the chest as well. Because Bloodlands gets stuck into an enemy for 3 seconds, 60% longer now, plus the percentage longer you can temper, dealing 80% damage to the enemy and all other lanced enemies. Which means I lance, and then I lance again, lance, and the longer they're in, the more consecutive cascading damage the enemy takes. which all gets vastly multiplied up. Mutilator played then, also together with a Blood Moon Breaches, going cry crazy. And don't forget that we have the Banished Lord's Talisman with that crit damage multiplier as well, if we so wish to. And since Bloodlines is really picking up Blood Orbs with Gorquilts and making bonus Blood Orbs, we're getting that 50%, that 70%. I'm looking forward to play Blood builds. And don't you forget that Blood Wave buff of actually triple the damage than before. We might actually see Blood Wave Rampage finally. And there's even a final blood item they buffed, and that would be Blood Artisan's Kuras. When you pick up 10 to 5 Blood Orbs, a free Bone Spirit is spawned. Well, this is now when you pick up 10 to 3 Blood Orbs. It still gives the bonus ranks to Bone Spirit, but Blood Orbs would also restore essence. And you get another 103.5% more damage for 4 seconds after picking up a Blood Orb. Interestingly enough, you could try to not boost Bloodlands as much as you want with a Mutilator played, and kinda get also the Bone Spirit in cooking together with this as you're picking up Blood Orbs, or you just simply wear this in a Bone Spirit build and create these Blood Orbs bonus by consuming corpses, by doing your corpse tendrils, and it's now better than ever. Every third is 3 per 9/10 Blood Orbs, where with the Blood Artisan's Kuras, you could get a maximum of 2 per 10 Blood Orbs if you have the best roll possible. And that only gets more the more orbs you pick up. And an interesting mention towards Overpower and Bone Spirit, the Lidless Wall that is providing huge amounts of armor, which now works finally correct, because the aspect of Shielding Storm used to be minimum life, now it's maximum life, and our Bone Storm will provide us maximum life barrier. They boosted the lucky hit chance of the Lidless Wall to make bonus Bone Storms by 15% up to 45%. But now the shield also enhances the Bone Storm duration. We don't even need a temper for this anymore. It has cooldown reduction, which you do need for the Bone Spirit build. Oh, and it gives you +2 to Bone Skills. Perfect for Bone Spear. Perfect for Bone Spirit. And yes, for Bone Spear, we're actually getting the Deathless Visage now with a 25% chance for Bone Spear projectiles to cast twice, which is a nice little increase and another 4 ranks to Bone Spear in total. Thank you very much, Blizzard. You're really thinking about us. That's not all though. Minions are getting a little something too, and that is the Ring of Mendeln, which used to have maximum minion life thorns useless. Well, it's now Int, Minion Attack Speed needed, and then another rank and scale to Warrior Mastery, Mage Mastery, and Golem Mastery, simply giving us a nice damage multiplier. Still, every 6th attack is going to lead to a big explosion, and not only to the big explosion, minions can overpower now. So they will anyways do more damage, even if you don't put anything into overpower, because they have a 3% chance to just randomly do an overpower with the high attack speed they have. That being said, since Blighted gets so heavily nerfed, I wouldn't go for the maximum Super Golem Slammer in the season. I would more focus on mages, because I think they should be turning out to be more efficient. To give you a feeling for how would this look now for the Bloodlands Necro, for example, which I've actually been playing on tier 100 pits very successfully farming that. It is one unique with the Mutilator played. Then you'll need the Blood Moon Breaches, which you anyways need for Bone Spirit, Blood Surge, Bloodlands. So you want to have the Blood Moon Breaches at any point possible. There is the options to play the Banished Lord's Talisman, which again, you do want to have for Bone Spirit on top of actually the blood builds. And technically, it would be good to have the Ring of Starless Skies if you can then fit it in, because there's actually something you also need, and that is ultimate cooldown reduction while you're picking up blood orbs. Then you also do need the Gorquilts on top, but that would already be 4 uniques. But now you're picking up blood orbs, you're also reducing the cooldown by picking up blood orbs, and then your blood wave would actually trigger 3 times. That is quite fantastic, as you're then resetting it, triggering it 3 times, then making more blood orbs, the blood orbs you're picking up to throw out more Gorquils, and again, Mutilator Plate actually giving you that Bloodlands duration, with your weapon being able to also temper Bloodlands duration up to 42.5%. And they buffed the Blood Tempers too, because they were too weak. Now it's 41.5 to 55%, up to a potential of 80% more blood damage as a temper. The blood overpower get increased to 105%. And if you want to go for the damage while fortified, because you're always fortified as a blood build, that could technically go up to another 80%. But even these are a small damage increase that then, with all the other blood increases, gets multiplied up quite nicely. Optimally, as a helm, we would rock the Harlequin Crest, and you kind of notice, like, a very good Blood build is looking a bit unique out of their mind. I mean, in Season 4, I wouldn't have been taking a single unique, or maybe one, if even, because tempering is just so good. Now it's looking like the more I have, the better it could be. The only sad loser of this patch in Season 5 will definitely be anyone interested in Shadow builds, Shadow Blight. I'm sorry. Yes, you got robbed. If you want to have the best results, we're looking here to play Bone Spirit. Corpse Explosion might be physical okay, but Shadow Corpse Explosion did actually get nerfed despite them buffing the Exfil's Corroded Signet. Maybe Sever can be played as a very nice crit build, but Shadow ain't looking that nice currently. But I gotta be honest, you got tons of options. You can still play minions, tier 100, tormented bosses easy. The overpower builds are gonna be great. What is it you're looking forward to? Don't you worry, I'll be providing at least 3 different necromancer builds for you to level from 1 to 100 that all have incredible endgame potential. And we'll obviously stream the whole thing live here on the channel as we're pushing to 100 and then show you how good these build will be. Tell us in the comments below what you're rocking and already check out how amazing the Bone Spirit build is already going to be. Thank you very much for watching. Have a fantastic good day.